Now, learning to FaceTime or Skype in your 70s or at any age, I'm joined in the studio by three special guests and their tutor as well, Mayte. Good morning to Mayte. How are you?
Hello, good morning, Alan.
Now, maybe I've used the wrong terminology as in tutor, because you believe that this is not so much like going to school. This is people meeting up and having a chat, a cup of tea, and learning about these things.
Yes, well, the cup of tea hasn't happened yet, really. But
the cup of tea hasn't happened?
No. It's just we are very, very busy. It's an hour and a half every week, and we just gather together people that have questions, ask the questions that are important to them. They could be about anything. It could be sending an attachment. It could be about something more advanced. But it's a very informal environment. We are not sitting in a classroom. We want to walk away from that. We want to walk away as well from computer labs, because it is we are not using that equipment. We encourage people to bring their own devices, and thus they are directing their own learning. It's their own agenda, basically. So
if you're using a laptop or if you're using your mobile phone, that's what you bring?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. So if you miss some session, that doesn't matter, because you are not missing anything that we have taught to the rest of the people, because the questions that you ask are relevant to you.
I love the title, MediasKool.
Okay, but thank you.
Yeah. Thank you for thanking me.
it's actually the Digital Learning Club where we are. It's my business, what has been sponsoring this last year until we somehow got some of the funding.
So now we're going to come back to you in a second, Mayte, because we've got a number of people here. We've got Bridget, we've got Gerry, and we've got Labam. But you are bringing this initiative to Gorey Library, to Enniscorthy Library, and to Wexford Town Library.
Yes.
So when are you doing that? Is it happening as we speak?
Oh, yeah. It started last week. We did our first session after the summer break in Gorey Library. For the first time, we did a session here in Wexford Town and in Enniscorthy Library.
At what time of the day are these sessions at?
In Wexford and Enniscorthy are from 11 to 12:30.
On the day?
On Tuesday.
Tuesday.
No, sorry.
You're okay.
I'm just going to go back a little bit.
Yep.
So Wexford is Thursdays in the library from 11 to 12:30. And Enniscorthy is Fridays from 11 to 12:30. Right. And Gorey is on Tuesdays from 2 to 3:30.
Yes. Gerry, we spoke before. Good morning to Gerry. How are you?
Good morning, Alan.
We met. It was the campaign, I suppose, back
we
in
did.
5 minutes.
Absolutely.
It was a wheelchair campaign.
Thanks for having us here this morning.
A pleasure. Now, and you're a regular listener to the programme, so it's a double pleasure to have
indeed.
You in the studio.
Thank you.
So you went along to this this event.
Yes.
And were you anyway computer or social media savvy at
Not
all?
Not at all, Alan. I had very little knowledge of technical skills, so I went completely with a hesitant and hopefully an open mind. My kids told me, don't say anything, because these aren't terms out of Star Trek. Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and all these words, WhatsApp. I didn't know what they were, Alan, until I got to this session that Mayte is running. Then all of this became easy, because what was quickly established in Mayte's sessions were, there's no such thing as a stupid question.
Right.
Every question is sensible, and you can go back over it next week, and there's tutors there to help us.
Right.
And whatever device you bring, that's the device you learn.
So the minute Mayte said that to you, you relaxed, obviously.
I did, yeah.
Because I have a friend who said the only thing that tweets in his house is his budgie. So what I'm saying, and there are a lot of people who feel that way. And I mean, I feel that way myself at times, because my own 15, 16-year-old son would blind me when it comes to
absolutely.
Knowledge.
Absolutely. My children are the same, Alan.
Yeah.
And
you feel a little bit, don't you feel a little bit
I feel very
out of
much
the loop?
Out of it, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
But now the door is
more
open.
You feel more in the loop now,
I do more in the loop now. And now I can relax and ask anything I want. I can go into areas that I never did before. And it's all good. Be it a tablet or be it a phone or an Android phone. Whatever it is, I do it
so
now.
So what did you bring with you? Because Mayte has said that you could bring whatever you brought with you.
I actually went after doing the Android phone, which I had only recently bought 2 years ago. I have since bought a tablet.
Yeah.
And now I'm learning how to use the tablet, the calendar, photographs.
The whole lot.
WhatsApp, everything, yeah.
Brilliant.
Contacting other people. It's just fantastic.
Right.
I'm able to relax within myself that I'm not doing something stupid. I'm sending wrong messages to people or...
Of the areas that Mayte mentioned, where do you go for your one?
Gorey Library.
Gorey Library.
Yeah, at 2 o'clock on a Tuesday, 2 to 3:30.
Right.
And it's only fantastic. And Alan, I'm 63 years of age. Yeah. I'm no spring chicken. I'm only starting to learn this.
Yeah.
And it's just great.
Okay. Labam.
Yes.
Come a little bit closer to that microphone there, Labam. Your experience then. So you went along. What were you expecting? And was it a surprise when you went there?
Actually, no, because I went, I attended some other sessions with Mayte before. And I know her expertise, so it was for me a wonderful opportunity actually to be able to go to her, to go to these sessions, and to be able to ask my question, my personal question, and that's a lovely thing about these sessions is because you can come at any level, you know, you don't have to be right down a learner, beginner. Or you can be somebody who's advanced but having a problem, a technical problem, or a problem with a specific...
So are you telling me you had a certain amount of knowledge?
I did have a certain amount of knowledge, yes, I did, because I worked as a manager and I was obviously having to work with a computer and do all the things then. But not in the way that I would like to have done it, was to surf the web, to get various information. I mean, the technology is an amazing, like an ocean, you know, it has depths and width, and there's so much to explore. So, yes.
So what did you bring by way of equipment?
I had a laptop.
A laptop.
And my phone. And the nice thing about it was that I learned how to actually transfer photographs from my phone onto the computer and then to organize it. And I realized that the computer could be a very good a secretary.
So you have benefited from it. And you're going of the sessions, you go...
I go to Gorey as well.
Bridget, your story then.
Good morning, Alan.
Good morning to you. So you wanted to go along. Were you tech savvy or had you a certain amount of knowledge or were you a total novice?
Well, my story started when I met Mayte through learning Spanish. I went to her to learn Spanish and she told me this wonderful idea that she had and would I be interested in helping her out. So her idea, of course, was the Digital Learning Club, and I said I would help her out in any way I could. Like Gerry, I'm 62 years of age. I wouldn't have a huge amount of computer knowledge, but I said to her I'll help her on the administrative side. So that's where we started, and I have been with her since day one, really, going along on a mentor sort of.
And do you see people coming in nervous to this and all of a sudden getting a surge of confidence?
Absolutely. People are of our era would have, as Gerry discussed earlier, when we were in school, we were told not to ask stupid questions. So we've got that inbuilt within us. So our age group sort of think, oh, I better not ask that question. I'll be laughed at. Or so this forum allows you to be totally comfortable, ask whatever question you like, you'll get an answer.
Gerry.
Alan, just one very important point I'd like to make, if I could.
Of course you can.
In the very first class that Mayte ran in the Gorey Library, it was on phones. I think there was 10 or 11 of us there. And I never heard of the word security on phones before. I'd never taught it anything about it. And when I was on the train up and down to and fro to Dublin to meet my kids and stuff, what little knowledge I did know, I was working away on the Irish Rail Wi-Fi, and I was transferring money from one account to another account.
Right.
And I didn't think anything of it until Mayte mentioned it as a big issue. Security on using your phones and laptops is a huge thing. I never gave it a second thought until Mayte brought it to light.
So it's far more than just learning
it's
how to use.
It's more than just learning. Yeah. It's making us secure.
Right.
Now, I use it at home.
Right.
And I play safe.
Okay. Any of you could take this one up. Skype is so important nowadays, particularly talk about children and relatives, etc., anywhere in the world. For many people, it's the way you manage to see them. A lot of people, I'm sure, listening to us this morning who may have relatives in Australia and America would love to avail of the services. Have any of you actually utilised Skype on the basis of what you've done at Mayte?
For people that have smartphones, we might encourage perhaps WhatsApp is way simpler.
Yeah.
As with the Skype, you tend to have an account. You need to find the other people that have an account. While WhatsApp is a matter of having a phone number.
Yeah.
And we like simplicity. Not make it overcomplicated. Maybe Skype doesn't like what I'm saying. I'm so sorry. But it is what it is.
But you're well within your remit to make things as simple as possible.
Because yes.
Ultimately, what I'm getting from all of you today is you want to make it easily accessible.
Yes.
So simple is where you want to go.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah. Right. You know, we have five well-known centres. You've got three of them. You, Ross and Bunclody, are going to be listening this morning saying, well, when is Mayte coming to Bunclody? When is Mayte coming to Ross?
It will be... I'm going to take this opportunity, if you let me, just maybe 10 seconds, to ask for people to come and help us. It's only an hour and a half per week.
Yeah.
And this idea needs for its success as well to bring on board other people that are willing to help.
But you're looking for people who may be retired, somebody with an hour or two to spare, and there's so many people au fait with this business. They could be look at the great work they're going to do, because for starters, people living on their own, if they have this, then all of a sudden they're not as much on their own as they think they are, because they have access to all their friends and family.
Yeah, but some people feel that they are, because they learn this later in life, they're able to do certain things, but they don't see themselves as tech savvy. And we're not looking for really high-tech technicians. What we are looking for, we are looking for them, really. But any person that knows how to do something can pass those skills to the person behind. So that's peer teaching, and this is a core.
I'm going to have to leave it there for the moment, but I'd love to come along to one of the classes at some stage and see it, because I might learn something myself. If people want to contact you, Mayte, what's the best way to do it?
Well, we
go along to any of the sessions.
That's
the best.
On Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, by
MediasKool.
Asking in the
MediasKool.
Yeah,
and it's spelled MediasKool as in KOOL. Thank you so much for joining us in studio. I now have to take up the phone and dial Japan and talk.